Hi everyone, I am Anil Kumar, motivational speaker. Today I am going to talk about revaluation, photocopies and challenging re-evaluation. So today I need to clarify on three aspects called revaluation. Why revaluation is required? Whenever the student is getting failed or getting low marks, so in that time, if the student has confident, has written in their exams, and as well as if he has a confidence on to improve his score, so in that time he will put revaluation. So in this re-evaluation, we need to pay some fees to the university. Like this year, 500 rupees we need to pay for each subject for re-evaluation. What is the benefit of re-evaluation? If the student has a confident that he has written very well, so in that scenario, we can put re-evaluation for failed subject, or if he got less marks also, we can put re-evaluation to increase his score. Many of the times, they will not give more marks, but sometimes may happen while recounting their marks. Sometimes they missed the marks. Sometimes technical error or human error. In that time, it will be very useful. If you put re-evaluation, maybe the student may get pass or student may get score easily. Then we'll come to photocopy. Why we have to take photocopy? There is no much benefit to get photocopy, because if you receive photocopy also, you will know what you have written in the examinations and what all those you have covered and how many pages you have written and what quality answers you have written. That and all you can cross check it. But only for your reference, you can take it, or you can show some other person also why, how you have written. But challenging re-evaluation and re-evaluation cannot be clubbed, means cannot obtain at a time. We can obtain only one, that is re-evaluation or challenging re-evaluation. Then what is that meaning of challenging re-evaluation? In challenging re-evaluation, we need to pay lump sum amount to the university. So if you get increased by the marks, means you may get some around 23 to 24. In challenging re-evaluation, if you get more than that marks, that 50% of the amount will be get refunded to your account. While admitting your re-evaluation, they used to collect your bank account number and IFSC code of the beneficiary. And for photocopy, you have to pay 400 rupees, and for challenging re-evaluation will be paid around 2100 rupees for each subject. So this is how it is as of now. Karnataka State Law University procedure for re-evaluation, photocopy and challenging re-evaluation. As I told you, you cannot at a time, you cannot take re-evaluation and challenging evaluation at a time. only one option will be available. Either you can go for re-evaluation, either you can go for challenging re-evaluation. So there will be a one we can go. So most of the people, they are not knowing about this. What is the benefit of these three aspects? So let us, I need to clarify in this video, what is re-evaluation and what are all the benefits, and what is photocopy and what are all the benefits. That is for your reference. You can keep photocopy. So that is also helpful to improve or score your good marks in your LLB. And challenging re-evaluation. In challenging re-evaluation also is toughest job. Most of the people are not going to the challenging re-evaluation. Only evaluation, re-evaluation, they go. Some of the people, some of the students may get passed. Some of the students may not get passed, especially. So I hope this video has given a clarity about re-evaluation and a photocopy of your answer sheet and challenging re-evaluation. So I hope my videos are very helpful for your especially for LLB students, 3 years LLB and 5 years LLB students who are studying under Karnataka State Law University. So please do subscribe my channel, Anil Kumar KT, LLB coach and motivational speaker, so that you will get benefit like this. And even who have been watched my videos and who have been subscribed to my this channel, for them also I would like to thank you.